Welcome to this video lecture. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about petroglyphs, and while there's many mysteries and ideas about them, we're going to talk one in particular. And we need to start with, what is a petroglyph? And a petroglyph, of course, is a symbol carved into the rock through the patina. Now, we're talking about here petroglyphs in North America, in particular the Great Basin style. And the way this patina, or this outer coating, is put on the rock is, in the heat of the summer, you'll get a thunderstorm, it'll rain on the rock gets wet, and then the sun comes along and dries the rock out and draws the water out of it, and with that water come certain minerals, and they get deposited on the outside of the rock, usually making the rock darker. And then all you have to do is take a rock and peck into it, and you go through this patina into the lighter colored rock, and you're able to make all manner of designs and symbols. And the Indians did this, and these symbols can last for thousands of years once they're done. One of the mysteries that we can see sometimes in some places is that as they weathered away color. That many of these symbols and petroglyphs at one time had color. And of course, color adds a lot of meaning to any symbol. Well, as we can see here on this glyph, if you look closely, you can see that it's actually pecked in, and then the red paint has been put over it. And that's, I think, the process that was done over and over again in this site. But this particular glyph is in just enough of an overhang where it's protected from some of the weather and some of the basic processes that make a patina. And so the paint, the red paint in this case, has been able to survive. It may be one of the oldest glyphs, but my guess is it's probably one of the newer glyphs, and that's one of the reasons why it still has paint. The older glyphs have long ago had their paint washed away, and this may be one of the youngest glyphs here, and that's why it still has some of its paint. And that can kind of tell us that many of these glyphs no doubt were painted, and maybe all of them. Now, when we start talking about having them colored, I think that may have had all kinds of significance. Of course, red in itself is a very emotional color. It's the color of blood and danger and that kind of thing. And so if you could add color to a glyph, you could essentially add meaning as well as beauty. And they would have had more than just red. There's a lot of copper minerals in this area, so they probably would have had a blue-green. Yellow is a very common color for the Native Americans, as well as white and black. And when you have a site like this that has hundreds, maybe even thousands of glyphs, this would have been a very colorful place indeed if the glyphs were red and yellow and green and so forth. And each would have had, of course, an increased symbolic meaning, as well as kind of an emotional impact of the site. But once we start realizing that some of these glyphs were painted, we can imagine all kinds of things. For instance, if they were painted different colors, they had different meanings, but also that the people that made these glyphs, maybe only the person, the artist that made the original glyph, was the only person to ever paint them. Or perhaps they were kept up for years, generations, where people would come to this site and other sites and would say things, well, we need more red paint, or we need more white paint because these glyphs need white, or this glyph was very faded last time we were here, and would have brought the colors here and then painted them over again and actually had an experience with the glyphs again. So we can look at this glyph here and we can wonder, is that maybe not only is it sheltered, But perhaps it's one of the last glyphs to be colored, one of the last times that a Native American came to this site that knew what to do and was part of the traditions of these glyphs, may have painted this particular glyph and done so in the proper manner and left it to us to wonder about the rest of these glyphs. And so we may be missing a lot of the emotional impact as well as the symbolic message that was once part of these glyphs because we don't have the color. So anytime you get into a glyph site, and if you can imagine it in color, I think certainly the emotional impact will be different, but also the way you would look at a symbol, whether a certain symbol is white or red, could make a difference as to what it means. And we're going to go across the water over here on this sandbar and look at another glyph that I think really gives us a clue as to whether the rest of these glyphs were colored or not. Now, when you looked at those lines, those colored, not colored, if you look to the right, you saw what might have been a spider, and there was actually a dot in the center of the body. Again, the symbolism and the clarity that would have been available if that dot was red, everybody would recognize that spider as a black widow spider. And the body might have even been painted a certain color, maybe blacker than the rock around it. So we have, again, color that can have a lot of meaning. Bighorn sheep, for instance, they're often kind of a grayish brown, but have a white rump patch. So if you see a glyph that's a bighorn sheep, an artist might have actually made realistic colors. And of course, you also have symbolic colors. For instance, in the Great Plains, they talked about the great white buffalo. Well, of course, these people didn't hunt buffalo, but they might have had the same idea of a symbol of purity of a white ram, let's say. And in fact, in a mountain range not far from here, there is a population, and we're about 4 or 5% of the population is pure white, just as snow white as can be. It's an amazing animal. I've seen a few of them in my time. These people did have good quality white paint. So they might have had, every now and then, you might have seen a normal colored sheep, and then once in a while, the great white sheep. Now, that's purely speculation, but these animals do exist, and so the concept could have existed, and I'm using that as, of course, an example of how color means something in the real world and would have been transposed to the symbolism of the glyph. You can see this over and over again within the glyphs, that some are symbolic, but in a way we really can't discern exactly what they are. And then others are much more obvious as to what they are. And then when you add to that the ability that these people had for color, it would be the most likely explanation of these glyphs that they used color, because they had the ability and that the symbolism would have been useful. And with that, I hope I give you something to ponder about these glyphs. I guess that's one of the things about petroglyphs that people really, there's just such a mystery. You know that it's a message. You know that these symbols had meaning to them. And some of them we'll never really know what they actually mean, and some of them we have some clues. I suppose their real value is just giving us something to ponder about ourselves and the people of the distant past, and how we're in some ways connected and in some ways very distant. And with that, I thank you.